Welcome everybody to the fifth and final part of the Budkai From the Depths 5K tournament. Today we are going to finish up all the fights. Everything is going to be resolved today. We should probably have about 6 to 8 different fights to see who is first, second, and third in this entire ginormous 28 entrant tournament. And right now I'm sitting on the IX jet, pretty much a crowd favorite because of its styling and its cool details, and also its amazing ability to win fights even though it's only 3,400 blocks large in a 5K tournament. It's pretty darn sweet, I gotta say. So just so you guys know, for the next tournament, if you make vehicles that are pretty, I will go ahead and maybe talk about them more and show them off more to the camera. Cause they pretty. So anyway, let me go ahead and announce the next tournament before we begin. The next tournament will be December 19th, and the only rule changes are going to be no subs, no repair bots, and no repair tentacles. And everything else is still okay, but it still will be 5K blocks. Just none of those three items. And I'm gonna have the details in the description below. For all the rules and how to submit and everything, which is pretty much just send the data.txt file to my email, but that's all going to be down in the below description. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and kick this tournament off and find out who our champions will be. Here we go, Clay's Bombardiers versus the IX Jet. Will the IX Jet be able to be fast enough to ignore the first volley here? And, oh my gosh, actually, I don't even know what the IX Jet's missiles are really going to even hit. Oh gosh, let's take a look here. Oh, looks like the lasers from down below are going ahead and penetrating the IX Jet. And uh-oh, have they put a stop to it? It looks like they might have stopped it in midair. Oh, this is going to be really bad. Let's go ahead and zoom back in on this. These missiles are coming at his tail section, but they are. Yep, his anti-missile lasers are going ahead doing an excellent job, although the frags are still getting through. So it seems. It seems the frags are still getting through and fragging up. Still hitting some of his components. Uh-oh. No, this looks pretty bad. Looks pretty bad. And also, just so you guys know, I had to make the IX Jet a friendly a spawn on my team because his fuel processor doesn't work unless he is not an enemy faction. Oh my gosh, and he's taking tons of damage though. Oh no, he's losing his tail section. He's dropping his bomb still though. He don't care. Well, he might start caring pretty soon. Alright, so looks like this fight's gonna be done. I believe the IX Jet has met his match. He's dropping bombs, but they're not really getting to where they really need to be going. It looks like he has stopped in midair. His custom jets have taken a serious amount of damage. Actually, I'd like to know how to make these custom jets. They look really cool. I never played with this yet, as it is kind of a new option to make these types of jet engines. But I'll have to maybe get into some of that. But it looks like the Bombardiers have won this round. Possibly, maybe the IX Jet can go ahead and get a better run for the next round. Now, a little word of advice for the next tournament, since there won't be any repair bots or repair tentacles allowed, I'm thinking evasion and shielding will play a major role in the next tournament, as you know, you need to kind of defend yourself from maybe an alpha strike, so you can go ahead and outlast the fight and do some damage, do some crippling attacks, maybe from behind, from the sides, some kind of tactics like that I feel will be very important and required. And I guess you could use shielding as in energy shielding, or you could use like steel plates for shielding of critical components, or you know, possibly have a strategy based on decoys just to buy yourself a few minutes or seconds before destruction. I think next tournament's gonna be very interesting, and since it is near Christmas, it's gonna help make the fights a little quicker for me as I do want to spend some time with the family as well. Because usually fights with lots of repair tentacles take a lot of time off camera for me to record, so so that's gonna help me out too. And I think it's gonna be more exciting because when someone gets hit, it's gonna be a permanent hit, and I think that's cool instead of everything just being reset. But okay, so what's going on here in this fight? We got some decoys here, flying chasing after the IX Jet, pretty crazy. But looks like they are smashing upon the mountaintops. Oh, that's so cool. And there's a million missiles. This is so cool. There's a million missiles coming at the IX Jet. But he's launching his volleys. Oh man, this is a cool shot. They're actually like all blowing up down here on the mountains, these flyers from the Bombardiers. Looks like the IX Jet is coming around for another attack run. Wow, this is amazing how far this fight's coming out. Or maybe he's running away. Hello, are you running away? I'm gonna have to get on this comm and figure out what's going on. Gonna have to put him on actual. But okay, all right. So I'm gonna cut back. I'm guessing he's gonna finish this guy off, and then he's gonna return to the main force. And this little dude has been silenced. He's been brought down by missile fire from the IX jet, and the IX jet looks like he's now turning around. Maybe either to finish this guy off or choose a new target once he's finished off. Pretty crazy the scope of this battle here, and the missiles are from the main bombardier array. They are falling down, as you can see there, as rain falls upon the Misty Mountains, or the desert. they're falling down because they're running out of fuel, and this guy's blowing up. Oh, heavy duty. Where the heck did that jet go? Oh gosh, I lost him. Oh, I'm not a good curator. Where'd he go? Ladies and gentlemen, the IX jet has left the building. Oh, there he is. Okay. There he is. He's like 50 million miles away. Okay, so I guess I'll cut back again once he gets closer to this hail of missiles, this missile wall. This is one brave jet. Looks like he took out that little fighter down there, finally. Dropped some bombs on him, but I think he's changing targets now. Looks like he's going over here. My camera can barely follow him. He's moving so fast. But he's going straight into the wall of missiles right there. Is he crazy? Is he giving it his one last ditch effort to save humanity? I think so. Will his anti-missile lasers be enough to take those guys out? I don't know. Let's see. Rushing as fast as I can. Oh, he is blowing up some balloons, though, with his laser. He's blowing some of them up. Oh, this is incredible. Wow. Wow, I didn't see. Look at that. Okay, so luckily he's still faster than the missiles can catch him. Although he is being hit by laser fire continuously from down below, from these below ships down here. So, yeah, that's a problem ship right there for him. And I think this might be, although he is dropping bombs, I think this might be his last run. Because look at all that fire he's taking. I mean, he's been getting hit this whole time. And he's a tank. I can't believe it. I mean, there's nothing really left of him. And he's still flying and shooting. It's a totally incredible design for 3,400 blocks. Wow. But I do believe the Bombardiers will win this one. Although, actually, they're kind of getting thinned out a little bit. Well, no, there's still a lot of them left. we'll see. We'll just have to see how it plays out some more. I can't believe it. After about 6 minutes of the IX jet spinning around over that way, his repair bots managed to get his tail section fixed, and he is back on track for bombing and dropping more fun times on the Bombardiers. And his biggest threat really was this laser guy right here, but looks like he is no longer operating at all. So I feel like the X-Jet almost has this one. I was almost going to call it as a Bombardier win, but I mean, like, with this guy down... Oh, there we go. With this guy down, yeah, he's doesn't really have a threat here, because he's taking out these missile threats quite nicely. Well, guys, I may have to give this fight to the X-Jet, because... Because he's going ahead and eliminated all the ground threats. They're all completely thrashed up. There's like nothing left of anyone down here. Including the laser guy over there. And there's no repairing being done. He's making short work of these balloons. They can't touch him with all his anti-missile lasers. And he's blowing them up. And there's really no one left, honestly, from the Bombardiers. I can't believe my eyes. So the X-Jet wins this round. Best 2 out of 3. This last round will decide who moves on to the final round. Okay, now it's up to the X-Jet to survive this initial volley where he struggled the first round. If he gets slowed down or spun around within the missile range, I feel like that's going to be a problem for him. Oh, and he's getting spun around, and if he's within these... Uh-oh. Yeah, darn it. Once he loses his speed, that is it. And if he's within range, if these guys don't start running out of fuel soon, then he cannot outlast this kind of damage. It cannot be done. But, oh my gosh, he's actually canceling a lot. He's canceling a lot of missiles. Look at them coming in. Coming in. They're hungry. They're running out of fuel. You gotta be kidding me. Oh my gosh. Oh, they were he's just out of range. Oh, now he has time to repair maybe. Okay, it's gonna be another long one. Alright, I'm gonna let this play out because, yeah, he's no longer in missile threat range. He might just win this one again. Alright. So it looks like the IX jet has been brought down. As the Bombardiers are no longer shooting, they're repairing, and he is... Wait, where the heck is he? He's out here somewhere. Is that him? Wait a second. He's still up there! You gotta be kidding me! He's having a dogfight out here. I thought that was him. That's really him. Oh, he's still just as fine as a rainy day. He's great. Okay. Oh, man. All right, so as he takes out this dude down here, the fight goes on. All right. Wow. Oh, I went to make a sandwich, and lo and behold, I hear some explosions, and I'm just like, oh, man, he got hit. He's, like, over the bombardiers. Now they're launching their missiles. He's obviously within missile range here, but he's also in range of dropping his bombs constantly. And he's smashing into things. Okay, so this is it. This is it, people. This is who's going to win here. He might be brought down, but he's like, his anti-missile lasers are amazing. They're just taking out these missiles like no problem. He's having no problems. Zero problems. If there's a missile, he's like, it's no problem. I got it. So, I mean, wait, is he repairing himself? Nah, it's just some twinklies. Okay, well, I can't believe this. I can't believe he's not going down. This is incredible. He's like the most incredible, like, look at this. He's just, now he's just bombing everything, like, non-stop. Non-stop bombing. Wow, there's like no words for this. And he's like ramming into things. He's like smashing these balloons. And if he hits the water, he may be dead then, but it doesn't look like he's gonna hit the water. He's doing good. Wow. This has to absolutely be the fight of the century. I mean, he's blowing up balloons, sending out rockets that are just coming on in, destroying this laser. This thing has no chance of repair now. There's no chance. And he's just flying around like a boss. Like, that's it. I mean, there's no more ground troops. Blowing balloons up. Look at that. Look at that. Can't believe the amount of DPS he puts out. And he's fine. He's totally fine. He's just cruising. I mean, like, he never really even got that hit. Hit that bad. He's just, like, primarily based on evasion and then anti-missile tactics. And look at this. I mean, this is quite the inspiration for the next tournament, I believe, as well. Because, like, all his evasion and all his anti-missile stuff, like, it's working. Like, he's just not even getting hit. It's just so awesome. And while the bombardiers had massive repair arrays, it seems like their repairing isn't keeping up with his damage and ramming and just all types of crazy stuff going on here. I mean, it's just, look at that. All right, so I'm going to call the winner here. The winner is, I can't believe it, the IX Jet, the 3400 block IX Jet has beaten the bombardiers. I know, a total upset. It's amazing. Crazy stuff, inspiration to all. All right, on to the next fights. Okay, so the Dirt Flies versus the Doom Ship. Doom Ship, I know, puts out a lot of DPS. We'll see see if his damage per second can go ahead and, oh, annihilate these flies. Wow, they got some serious repair going on here. But he's got some serious offense. Let's see how this fares. I mean, oh, his purple shots are going up, and they are connecting. Ooh, they're connecting. They're cutting them right in half. Look at that. Cutting that dirt fly right in half. How is he still moving? I can't believe he's gonna get cut in half. He's literally gonna get cut in half. There he is. He's cut in half. He just doesn't even know it yet. Oh, now he knows it. Yep. Wow, it's unbelievable. What a spectacular explosion. Well, or a spectacular, oh my gosh. Look at him go. Can he keep up this volley of damage? Can he do it? Does he have the ammo generation to keep going? I mean, like, let's see. Does he have elevation barrels? No, he just has motorized barrels. But looks like he can get the angle that he needs for destruction. Wow, what a cool ship. Oh man, is this it? Is this all the dirt flies got left? Oh, I like these. I like the helicopter blades. Even the helicopter blades floating on the water are being destroyed. Unbelievable. Wow. Well, that was a quick fight. All right, let's best 2 out of 3. If the Doom Ship moves on from this round, I think that could finally spell disaster for the IX Jet. As just his sheer laserness and his DPS that he puts out with all his cannons. Although then again, possibly the speed of the IX Jet may save him again. That could be the case. I mean, we've seen crazy things happen around here. But unfortunately, the Dirt Flies, I guess mantra of slow and lasery and high, don't seem to be working quite well against the Doom Ship. Oh, but darn it. Wow, they're getting taken down so fast by this extreme amount of damage. I mean, I wonder what kind of cannons. Looks like the kinetic damage of these rounds must be around, like, 800. And I'm guessing he's just totally maxed out, like, the explosive and armor-penetrating roundness of these rounds. Roundness? Yeah, something like that. Yeah, I mean, it just seems he's taking it to the max, the Doom Ship. Totally crazy. Cut these flies literally in half. Wow. Alright, so Doom Ship's got this one. Well, I guess there's one more fly to go, but I think he's got it. I mean, oh wait a second. It's not a fly, it's a half a fly. Oh, cool engine design though. Oh yeah, I see the lasers and stuff. We get a little sneak peek of what's inside this bad boy here. But yes. Yes, that is the end of it. Okay, so Doomship moves on, and he will face the IX Jet in the finals, yeah. Okay, so here we have the Brigade versus Asylum Wing. Will the Brigade of Sea People Funny Creatures go ahead and destroy what we have above here? Oh, looks like they're sinking, though. Yeah, that's good, that's good. Sinking enough, sinking. Okay, good, good. Just to kind of outdo these missiles here. I may have started them a little too high above the water. No, I think they'll be fine, though. Okay, let's see what kind of damage they're doing to... Oh yeah, those missiles are stopped. Yeah, they went ahead and sank down there. Their strategy of sinking seems to be working. And what do we have over here? Not really too much is going on. Not really too much. I mean, okay, we got a lot of repairs going on here. It's like repair max. Oh wow, look at this. This is some nice shielding we got here. But these lasers look like they'll be the ones doing most of the work against the Brigade down here underwater. Mm-hmm. Well, let's see here. Oh, there's some explosions happening here and there. Let's see. But the missiles... that's a shame. Oh, yeah, that's right. Asylum Wing have their space missile launchers, but doubt those are going to be doing much in this fight. And the lasers do seem to be penetrating some of these sea people down here from the Brigade, but they are repairing one another just fine. All right, so I will come back to this. Looks like here comes another volley of missiles at the mothership, of Asylum Wing. And the missiles are coming up from underwater, swinging their way up here. Some are connecting, even though there's a little missile defense here. They are connecting. This guy's repairing like mad, but I don't think he's repairing enough for the amount of damage that's coming in through here. I mean, like, yeah, he's pretty much a skeleton now. And I'm not even sure if the Brigade is going ahead and targeting. Oh, they're still targeting him. But they are targeting some of the space arrays, so it seems. I believe these guys got this one in the bag. As these missiles float up, I think they'll go ahead and engage. Oh, those are just like the enemy missiles. Oh yeah, he's being brought down. It's just a matter of time. Yeah, his engines are gone now too. Just a matter of time now before... well, look at those missiles in the water. Alright, well, we will... I'll keep this going a little longer. And we have one of the satellite arrays crashing into the water. He is coming down, getting hit. And there's nothing he can do about it. He had a nice, decent shielding array, though, for himself. To keep shots from hitting him. But looks like some frags have come in, and they have grounded him. Oh, and this guy looks like he's falling as well. He's got hit by some frags. He has a few repair bots on there, but he is flying... oh, wow. Oh yeah, he got nailed big time. Okay. Wow. Okay. So it looks like to me... Oh, this guy's done too. Everyone's done. Alright, so it looks like the Brigade has won this round for sure. Okay, Asylum Wing coming at him. At the Brigade here. Let's take a look at what is going on here. So the Brigade is run by Carl. And Cern has the Asylum Wing command. But it seems like much of the same as before. Oh, actually, some of them didn't even get up in the air there. Uh-oh. Wow. Being brought down right off the bat. Oh, I know they wanted minimum range, more or less. I think Cern wanted mid-range. Brigade wanted shorter range. But yeah, okay, so it seems to me. Yeah, we got some decoys flying, repairing up here, but they're being downed by the missiles. Doesn't seem like they're fast enough to go ahead and deny these missiles their hits. Wow, okay. Trying his best. The mothership, the flagship of the Asylum Wing is trying to get airborne. But even with all this repairing from all his friends, he is not doing it. And he's drowning, he's sinking. Oh no. I mean, I guess this is the lasers coming from underwater. It's kind of hard to see the underwater aspect of this. Oh, there's some lasers. You can kind of see it like this. So yeah, those underwater lasers are going ahead and doing their job. Yeah, zapping away, doing the majority of the damage that we cannot see. So to us, it seems like everything's just evaporating. But yes, it's evaporating due to heavy lasers underwater. And unfortunately, that is a strategy that is winning this tournament so far. But next tournament, there will be no subs, so we'll be able to see more of the action on top of the water. But okay, so I'm going to go ahead and give this to the Brigade. I feel like they have won this. Carl's forces have won in spades. Kablamo. Look at that. Okay, alright, so on to the next fight. The Great Retro versus Disco Box. Yeah, my favorite Disco Box. Wow, that's a bunch of damage there. I don't think he can dance his way out of this one. Let's see here. Let's take a look at least the insides. Alright, so lots of laser tubes. Very nice. Still shooting, though, even through his own lasers. He's like, I don't care. I'm gonna shoot through myself. He can't really do so. Uh-oh. I think things are breaking in here. I don't think things are working very altogether in this. Yeah. That's a nice engine, though, kind of, from what I can tell. Okay, so this monstrosity over here has won this round. I doubt the next round will be any different. That's pretty scary. I will also be adding a new rule to the next tournament that every vehicle must have propulsion or some kind of movement capabilities and not be, even though that is still considered a vehicle, it has no movement, so it would be disqualified for next tournament. Every vehicle must have movement or a propeller or some kind of engine of sorts to go ahead and be able to move itself around. That's going to be an addition for next tournament. But for now, the Great Retro is moving on, as he has destroyed the Disco Box. That is it's quite a shame, because it was really fun to watch Disco Box do its thing. Oh wow, this is a pretty cool view. Pretty scary. Yeah, look at all the bullets flying through here underwater. They don't care. They're like big enough, thick enough of bullets that they just kind of, big destruction. But okay, alright. So we have our final four. And it's time to go on to the finals. Here we go. I guess here's the list of what's been happening so far. So you can see where everyone's competing. So, alright, let's do it. Continuing on. So here we are, final fight. Will the X-Jet... Oh, no. Not this time around. He can't quite dodge this, what the Doom Ship has to bring. Definitely not this time. Didn't even get a chance to get a volley off. But he is quite tough. But not tough enough. Oh my, there he goes. Okay, so Doom Ship has won this round. X-Jet was not able to dodge the rounds coming in. Will the Doom Ship be able to bring this guy down one more time? Oh wow, quite a bit of chop here, but doesn't seem like, no, he's just way too much DPS here, way too much DPS. The Doom Ship wanted any range to start. X-Jet wanted a little further of a range, but doesn't seem like he was able to, he still has a chance to drop some bombs and shoot some right now, but his main laser battery is gone, and he is blowing up from the center. Wow, Doom Ship has a habit of cutting things in half, I tell ya. He really does. Alright, so this is a pretty clear winner, though. Doom Ship is vastly overpowered, has vastly overpowered the IX jet. But it was a wonderful entry. I really enjoyed the jet while it was here, while it lasted. But the Doom Ship is awesome as well. So, alright, on to the next fight for the final battles. Both Retro and Brigade wanting short range. This should be a pretty quick fight if these bullets can go ahead and penetrate underwater. don't look like they can. Looks like they are stopping midwater here as the missiles are attacking the, oh my gosh, look at all those bullets. Oh, looks like they are penetrating. They are doing a bit of, damage underneath here as the missiles are penetrating the, okay. Missiles are skipping about, but it looks like these guns are shooting underwater. Oh, but they're getting taken out. They're not quite that durable. For what they have in offense, they lack in defense. Oh yeah, these guns are taking some serious damage, but they are putting out some good bullets here underwater. But are these bullets flying here gonna have enough kinetic damage to take out the brigade of sea people? I don't think so. I don't think so. Looks like he's maybe taking out one, but their repair between all three of each other is should be enough to keep them afloat while he takes his damage. And his bullets are going underwater. I love that. That's a cool effect, but such a dampening effect is a huge defense for the Brigaders. So yeah. Oh, so there he goes. Okay, so the Brigade wins this round. Best 2 out of 3. Out on the ocean, a war rages. Who will be victorious? Looks like all the bullets are literally bouncing off. He always targets this black and red guy. Bullets, but I see the bullets bouncing off, though, the design. I mean, I guess they are doing some damage. Maybe hitting some explosive barrels underwater, so it seems. But yeah, I think it's going to be the same result as before. Funny thing is that these end battles seem to be rather quick. It seems like everyone has quite a bit of offense towards the end of the tournament here, and they get taken out pretty quick. I mean, like, our first fight was, like, what, like, 12 minutes long? And these are, like, about 30, 40 seconds each. But that's all cool. It's all good. Let's take a view from under here. All right, so lasers going off. Missiles going off. I hear explosions. Oh, there's an explosion happening down here. It looks like this dude's getting taken out. But, he's still launching missiles, though. Oh, it's just his decoy ammo barrels down here that are exploding. But he's still got, he's still being repaired, and he has two other friends here that are shooting him. I really like how these guys crawl, though, on the sea floor. That's pretty cute. Look at that. Just like, hello. Just crawling along, moving, strafing. And what do we have up here? Nothing really left. Okay. So, the brigade makes it on. Carl's brigade makes it on. Versus, I guess, Kurt's doom ship. But before we do that, let's have the let's have a round for third. The fight for third place. Will the IX jet be able to dodge? Oh, this would be really interesting. Will he be able to dodge the Daka that's flying at him? So it seems he has. Let's take a look at these bombs here. What are they going to do to the framework of this? Oh my gosh, this is awesome. Look at this anti-air. Oh no, he's getting connected. Oh, the sheer amount of... Oh, but he's somehow still flying. He's somehow... Oh, I like how there's predictors there so we can see where the shots want to go. Oh, he may get lucky here. If he keeps spinning like this at this range, these shots may not adjust in time to... He may not adjust. Okay, yeah. Alright, cool. Oh man, this is too close not to, like... I gotta keep recording this. Anytime he could just, like, get hit by this huge volley of shots. I mean, they might run out of ammo eventually. He may make them expend all their ammo reserves. And then they may be shooting a lot slower. And by then, he could repair. Oh, looks like he's almost repairing. Alright, I'm gonna have to cut back. Oh, the IX jet's getting hit again. He repaired. He was going for a run. He was going for a run, and then he, yeah, he's getting shot up some more. Oh my goodness. I'm not sure who's gonna win this one, honestly, because it looks like they are taking some good damage down there as well. So, he's dropping his bombs. Oh, IX jet might win this one. He might get third. That'd be crazy. Oh, a stream of shots coming in from the distance. My camera is so far back, trying to follow this jet. Oh, he's dodging or getting hit. Oh no, he's going straight into the line of fire. Oh, but there are only like a few guns left and he's pulling out. I can't believe it. Oh, it looks like he's actually lost control. He's flying like straight up and he's gonna stall and he's gonna get shot. Looks like he's stalled to run out of fuel or something. Looks like he's taking some, I'm trying to rush the camera over here as fast as possible. Oh no, he's stalled in the air. He went straight up, stalled the engines. Now he's getting hit with only the few guns that are left of the Great Retro. He's doing some bomb drops, though. He's doing some of that damage. Wow, what a tank of a plane. I can't believe how strong this plane is. Can't believe it's just like... Oh, how is he not getting... Oh, okay, yeah. How many guns are left down here? There's one gun left. One gun left firing. And it looks like that was enough. Looks like that's enough. If he can somehow take out that gun with these last missiles. If he can do it. Oh no, looks like he's gonna evaporate before that gun evaporates. Oh, baby. Oh. Oh. One gun. Oh, he stopped shooting. He's still shooting. I can't believe how close this fight is. Oh, really? Oh, are those even gonna hit? They're not even really hitting. Oh my gosh, you gotta be kidding me. Alright. Oh, this could be it. What are those, bomb drops or missile drops? Oh, they went in the water. I'm gonna have to keep an eye on this. Never mind, the missiles actually bounced back out of the water. They bounced up and down, up and down. Look at that. Look at them. They're like, is that what it is? Is that what it's gonna take? What happens? Did that do something? He's still shooting. I can't believe this. Still shooting missiles. Look at this guy. Look at him, he's a skeleton. He's not even like... He's got holes all around him. Still shooting missiles. A ton of repair bots flying after him. But yeah, he's still shooting missiles. But I think once he hits the water, that's going to be the end of it. Because like, I don't think he's going to be able to raise himself out of the water. But he's given a good fight though. What the heck is he even shooting here? What is this? What is that? What the heck? He's got like a few missiles left. Are they even... They are actually making it over here. I can't believe it. That's ridiculous. Oh, here we go. I think this is it. Okay, so... yeah, now it's just a matter of time of getting shot. Yep, the IX jet has been silenced. Its core has been taken out. And it has no defense against the shots coming in, even from the single cannon there. This is a very close fight. Very close fight. Alright, so the Great Retro wins this round. Best 2 out of 3 for 3rd place. Okay, what will happen in this fight for 3rd place? The jet is making it in with a volley of bombs, as before. But will these bombs even do much against the framework? I mean, as we've seen before, they didn't really do too much. The cannons are shooting away. Let's have a look at what these bombs do as these cannons are shooting at the plane. Different vantage point than last time. Alright, so the bombs are flying up and taking out some of the guns, in fact. Yeah, they're doing quite a good job. But the guns are taken out. The IX jet, still a good amount here shooting. He's put off balance, but he's not quite spinning as violently as before. Alright, well, I'm going to have to leave it, and I'll get back to you guys. There seems to be something coming in here. Alright, there we go. Oh, he's getting nailed again with his direct route attacking. Looks like he's going for a spin again, but these guns are taking serious damage from all the missiles that are just flopping on in here. And he's taking off again out of the range with missiles incoming. Slowly, these guys are getting whittled down. What looks like there's only one gun that's really doing anything right now. Let's see what these missiles do. If they take out this guy here, they take this guy out. There's not really going to be much of an offense left for the weapons platform supreme. Yet again, another attack run. Will there be any difference this time around? Will there be a critical hit somewhere? Doubt it. There's a lot of these cannons from the Great Retro. Oh, he's been stopped. Okay, maybe that's what they needed. That was a critical hit. Let's go ahead and take a look at this jet. If he can go ahead and repair himself. There's an explosion happening. Where's that coming from? Oh, looks like it's from the jet. Oh boy. Oh, he's getting majorly messed up now. Oh, his laser's been taken out. Oh, darn it. Just when we thought he could have possibly won this round. For third place. Looks like the Retro's gonna go ahead and get third place. As of right now, oh, he's showing his, like, tasty side right here. He's showing it. Showing his belly. To the incredible guns. To the bullets that are... oh, but luckily, that shield's doing some work. They're actually deflecting quite nicely. Wow. Like 10 out of 10 are deflecting. That's nice. But I fear once he hits the water, this might be a different story. As he, he just has enough engine power to go ahead and repair that. Oh my goodness. No, I think this is it, though. Because, like, unlike last time, where there was only one cannon remaining, there are actually, wait a second, there's only one cannon shooting. What the heck? Uh-oh. These bombs might go ahead and collide with himself. Oh, what the heck? All right. So, what's happening? Okay, now he's getting... yeah, now he's getting smashed. This could be it. Yep, there we go. It just blew up. I just noticed, like, a whole ton of ammo barrels here that were lined up along the insides of this guy, and they just all blew up. There's, like, literally... I wonder if they're... oh, are they gonna be repaired back again? Yeah, it looks like it. Yeah, it looks like they're gonna get put back, but I don't think they're gonna last for that long again. Yep. Oh, there we go, there we go. Another explosion. Getting cut in half. Quite the damage coming in here. Yeah, alright, it looks like the Great Retro, has won third place to me. Let me take a look at my list here. The Great Retro by Vorfine. Congratulations, you have gotten third place. And good job, IX Jet, like I said before. Very inspiring design, very good design with limited blocks. But now you're catching a blaze. Alright, so on to the final fight for first and second. Championship fight, go! Alright, so this is all pretty much underwater. Not too exciting. I believe these shots will do nothing. Oh, here come the missiles, uh-oh. So it's really up to the lasers on the Doom Ship to go ahead and get the dirty job done. As I believe he probably can do. Missiles coming in, but do they have the fuel to get here? I think they do, right? I think they got the fuel to come here and get the job done. Yeah, they're kind of... oh, but looks like the anti-missile lasers on the Doom Ship are, in fact, getting rid of the majority of the missiles coming in. Oh, but some will be connecting, though. Oh, some will be taking some big damage here. Not like his front guns were doing much anyway. All right, let's go take a look at what's happening underwater here. That's really where the big fight is happening, at Master Roshi Island. This is where, like, This is where the tournament happens. Okay, so, so it looks like they're all still shooting and moving forward. Okay. Oh! But the way that they're oriented is, whoa, that's pretty loud. The way that they're oriented is they're only shooting one of their lasers each. Okay. And it looks to me like the Doom ship's pretty much done. I mean, like, my goodness. Missiles still coming up from under the water. Doom ship has been silenced. I guess because he didn't have too much to repair, too much repairability, as the sea creatures down below here, the brigade, they are, I really have a tough time saying that, the brigade are repairing one another and shooting like mad as they move forward to their enemy. Yeah, they fine, they almost like 100% good. But they better enjoy it for now because there's no subs next tournament. That's right, I know a lot of people wanted me to include subs in the previous tournaments, so I was like, okay, I'll include subs. But now it's time to go ahead and have a sub-free tournament, as they have they're very strong to denying a lot of damage types. But okay, all right, so best 2 out of 3. Here we go for the champion. The Doom ship wanting any range, I have went ahead and adjusted the range here to be a little closer, as the brigade wanted short range more or less. So we'll see how this fares here, but I feel like the results will be the same. Yeah, and if you guys ever have questions about me spacing people out, that's why I usually take the average of two people's suggested ranges, and then sometimes I'll mix it up between one other person's preferred range and the other person's preferred range, and it's pretty much how it goes. So pretty much it doesn't really matter what kind of range you specify, because as it'll most likely be, you know, back and forth. But okay, so here we go. Yeah, it looks like the Doom ship has already been silenced. That is done. It's a done dealio. Doom ship gets second place. And the brigade, the little cute little sea people down here below on the ocean floor, they have won the championship round of the Budkai 5K. Congratulations, Carl. Your designs of repairing sea creatures has won the day. Yeah. And I am looking forward to the next tournament, guys. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be more of a classic styling, as we won't have so many odd designs of submarines and such things like that. Till next time, I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.